हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? वेलकम टू योर ओन चैनल मीडू स्टडी। आई एम योर फ्रेंड आशुतोष फ्रॉम IIM इंदौर। एंड फ्रेंड्स, एज यू ऑल नो, मीडू स्टडी इज योर ओन चैनल इनिशिएटिव इन विच वी डिस्कस वेरियस मैनेजमेंट टॉपिक्स सब्जेक्ट्स इन अ वेरी सिंपल मैनर। फ्रेंड्स, इन मीडू स्टडीज वी हैव 5 डिफरेंट मॉड्यूल्स करंटली, विच आर ऑपरेशंस मैनेजमेंट, स्ट्रैटेजी, HR, OB एंड मार्केटिंग। एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड ऑल द वीडियोज ऑन स्ट्रैटेजी, मार्केटिंग एंड HRM। टुडेज वीडियो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स इज ऑन ऑपरेशंस, एंड एज यू कैन सी it is 10th video in the series production and productivity 2. So if you have not seen first video, please see, because then you will have a link, you will understand what is production, what is productivity. You can go to the playlist and see video number 9. And in last video we also started aggregate planning, we discussed that. Today we will study about the strategies of aggregate planning. So I will suggest that you first refer what is aggregate planning. There are two strategies, my dear friends. First is known as level strategy. So maintaining a steady rate of regular time output while meeting variations in demand by combination of outputs. What does this mean? I will explain it from a graph. Let us see the graph in next slide, then you will understand. So see, demand is fluctuating. It can be a sine curve, it can be a zigzag, anything. But when you plot your units and time, units, how many number you are making. If you are into, for example, shirts, and it is about month, so 3000 units. So basically you are plotting the units, and this is the time frame per day, correct? Or maybe monthly, depending upon what time frame you are comparing. So demand is a fluctuating curve, but like you see, production remains constant. So if you are making 1000 units per month, demand is maybe 300, demand is maybe 2000. Your production remains fixed at the rate of 1000. This, my dear friends, is known as your level strategy, means maintaining a particular level. Now in level, basically maintaining strategy, what is the alternative? Alternative is inventory based alternative. Basically you can build the inventory, correct? Building inventory when you are in the lean season and you know that in future there will be requirement, because here number remains same. So even if demand was down, correct, against 1000 demand was maybe 700, that 300 is additional inventory. So you can end up building inventory. Second can be backlog, back order or shortage. Again, it is the other approach. So here, instead of building, what you are doing, some previous order which was there. Now consider that 1000 and next month order is 1600. So 300 was the backlog and remaining is in the next month. So that is how the second strategy is there. These are known as inventory based alternative. And thus, by all this study, you can understand that the key feature of level strategy is inventory is the critical link between the periods, made to stock environment products with low risk of obsolescence. Let us take one by one. Critical link between the period, what? Inventory. So whatever inventory you are maintaining between the months, that is a very critical link. Second, made to stock environment is there, means you are not made to order. Second approach which we will study, that will be make to order. Whatever order is coming, you are making. Level strategy is made to stock, you are making to stock, and it can be done with products with low risk of obsolescence. Obsolescence means becoming redundant. For example, paint, for example, something to eat, that are not becoming obsolescence. But now come to fashion industry or mobiles. You are into making some apparels and you start stocking. But what happens after 4 months, whatever you had made, that becomes old fashioned. People will say you are selling old fashioned products. So you don't do level strategy where there is high level of obsolescence risk. Only in case of low level, you can use level strategy. Opposite to this now comes the chase strategy. As the name suggests, you are chasing something. In cricket, what are you doing? You are chasing a particular score. Matching capacity to demand, the planned output is expected demand for the period. So whatever period, for example, January month, demand is 600. Company's expectation from the manufacturing will be to make 600. Next month it is 1000, you have to make 1000. Then it is again 800 down, you have to make that. So basically what are you doing? You are matching capacity to demand. Let us understand from the graph. That same units versus time graph, if this is your demand, which was there previously, there production was a straight line, that is production was remaining constant. Your demand was going down, still production was here. Demand was going up, still production was here. Here what is happening? Your production is following the demand curve. This is basically known as chase strategy. In chase strategy, there can be various AOP alternatives, and there are two types, my dear friends. One is known as capacity adjustment, second is known as capacity augmentation. Let us discuss them one by one. When we say capacity adjustment, you are adjusting the capacity. First measure of it can be overtime and undertime. Whenever there is more requirement, you give overtime to the people. Instead of 8 hours, you say you work 2 more hours, 10 hours, and I will give you more salary. Opposite to it, demand is down. You ask them that I will pay less, you please work only 6 hours. That is known as undertime. Second is variable number of shifts. In the company, so for example, 8-hour shift is there, one shift. So in a day, you can basically have 3 shifts, correct? Considering you have infrastructure in which night work is also possible. So what you are doing, you are making variable number of shift. So in peak period, maybe you have even 3 shifts. In lean period, you have only 1 shift. Hiring and layoff the workers. What you are doing, when you require more output, you hire people. When you require less output, you fire people. Second, instead of capacity adjustment is known as capacity augmentation. In this, the first method is subcontract or outsource. What that subcontract or outsource means, that some part of your work you are outsourcing, giving it to someone outside. That is known as outsourcing. De-bottleneck. In various processes, in various operations, there can be some bottleneck in terms of process. Whenever we see bottleneck, that means something which is basically reducing your capacity, your output. So you are de-bottlenecking it. Okay, these are capacity augmentation. Now in chase strategy, let us discuss an example which is of hiring and firing to meet demand. If we see, there were 3 different alternatives. One was undertime, overtime. Second was variable number of shift. Third was hiring and firing. So, or layoff. Layoff and firing are same. So here we are considering the third. In question, you are given 6 months, for example, Jan to June. How much is the demand? So you can see 4,500, 55, 7,000, 10,000. In April month, demand is even more than the double, correct? And then it further reduces. Then days of month, how many working days are there? That is plotted. Hours per workers per month, how many hours per workers per month is available? Units per worker. So basically in Jan, one worker can make 1063 units. And this is the basically salary. Now, questions can be, for example, for different months. Let us take first question, how much hiring and firing is required? Basically, we are asked to calculate number of manpower. So what will be your approach? In that approach, first of all, let us assume that your current workforce is 7 workers, 7 people you have. Demand we got is 4,500. Now, in some cases, beginning inventory can be given. It can be 0 also. But normally it is not 0 because in December you would have produced something and there would be always some leftover. So then you calculate the net requirement. Net requirement will be demand minus the beginning inventory. So 4,500 minus 250, which is 4,250. Now you calculate how many workers you require. To do that, what you will do, you will divide this 4,250 by 1063, this particular number. How many units a worker can make? So 4,250 divided by 1063, which comes to 3.99, which is 4 workers. So workforce was 7 and you require 4. So means you have 3 additional people. So 3 people can be fired. This is how you calculate. Now similarly, let us build this table for other months also. Demand, beginning inventory, this was January we already calculated, correct? Now let us move to further months. Here complete whatever was there in stock is required, is finished, sorry. Now other months demand will be basically the net requirement. Now required workers, how to calculate? First of all, calculate this required workers. Just divide this net requirement by units plus worker, per worker, sorry. So 5500 divided by 918. 7,000 divided by 1,000, 10,000 divided by 1,015. You are calculating the required number of workers. Now understand this table. This we have seen that we require to fire 3 people. Now when we move to February, your workforce was 4 and your requirement is 6 people. So what you will do? You will hire 2 more, taking the workforce to 6. In March, so basically you need to see the previous month, basically what is the opening manpower and what is the requirement. Here you require 7 people against 6, so hire 1 more, it comes to 7. April you require 10 people, so hire 3 more, so your workforce moves to 10. Now go to May. Till now you are only hiring. Now demand has started decreasing, so requirement of worker is also down. From 10 it has come down to 8, so you need to fire 2 people. Now it has gone down to 6, so one more people, correct? So this is how your hiring and firing strategy works to aggregate the demand, whatever requirement is there. So friends, this was one example. In next video, we will discuss some more strategy and more examples for production and productivity, and we will complete this topic. If there is any confusion, you can write on medu.study@gmail.com. If you are liking the content, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you friends, take care.